Looky! Isn't it pretty? So Henny Penny gives me her second ever egg at 12 weeks old, twice the age she's supposed to have to be for eggs. And she tried to hide it from me. I just cleaned up their little litter pan, and I want to show you where she laid before it gets too dark. It was back on this brick. Isn't that funny? I was just thinking about taking the bricks out because they get kind of yucky. A little dark, but at least you can see them. I'm also really considering cutting a window and putting plastic and wire over it on this side. Yes, also plastic, because that way their little like wind protection zone remains. But she'd get a lot more light that way and probably start, she just likes to hang out on the dark side. I have a very dark bird for a golden. So that's exciting. My second ever laid by my own hen egg. The other one was like a week ago at least, I think. At least. But I guess she settled into her new spot. And, you know, they're very low maintenance. I only actually have to give them water every 3 or 4 days in this dispenser even. And the bin of food, like once a week if even, for just the two of them at least. So this is easy. It's going really well, and it'll be interesting. I am wondering if I'll be able to tell if this egg she gave me is fertile. That would be neat to be able to tell. There's a little dot on the yolk of any egg that you crack. And at least on quail eggs, the way you can tell is that it looks more like a little bullseye instead of just a white dot. The yolk has like that one little dot, and then some, like when you're separating the yolk from the white, it's the part that's like kind of still attached. That's basically like the umbilical cord, but if there's no fertilization, then there won't be a little like pinkish dot in the middle. And you can eat the eggs fertilized or no. And nothing will develop unless you incubate it. So the most you'll ever see is that little dot in the middle of the existing dot. That's really it. Unless you keep it at 100 degrees, and then something might start to develop inside. So, yeah, it poured today. I was bicycling. I am thinking that I might do a video on rain gear for cycling, because I got some really cheap options worked out extraordinarily well. I was pretty shocked. I harvested from the front. I harvested the elderberries. I am seeing that I need to go around and harvest the milkweed pods again. I did start putting them in the freezer because I can't use them as fast as they're coming. And I'm just hoping that that works out, because I have no proof or anti-proof as to whether that'll work. And additionally, over here, when I was harvesting my elderberries, I accidentally pulled a branch off. And so I thought, let's just see if it grows, because elderberry's kind of known for that, like, growing without much effort thing. I'm going to start doing the weeding as I walk around my jigger again. Oh, look, that's not grass. Do you know what that is? This is grass here that I just dropped. That's grass. But this one here, that's spiderwort. That's that cooked green that I really, really like. But also that is a native, and also is kind of weedy. Grows a lot. Grows a lot. And will take over if given the chance. So I will probably plant this on the cliff and go around and pick some pods off of the milkweed. And it doesn't look like I have any green beans yet. I'm still getting a few stragglers on the peas, but the pea vines are definitely dying at this point. They're cool weather crops, so I'm shocked that it's August and they're still kicking. You can see what I'm talking about up there. And over here. And then there's still some up in here. They're great food. New colors, very damp colors. The echinacea are making a comeback from the last groundhog eating them all up. I have not successfully gone after this most recent groundhog. It's the quail litter in the top there. So yeah, a lot less elderberries on there. That's kind of the precious right now. I've been fermenting it so that I have my own homemade sambucol, which is an immunity booster, and all considered, what with the pandemic going around at all, it's a very good idea in my mind to go ahead and have that available. It sure makes me feel better about the world in general. I hit the jackpot today. So in addition to getting caught in the rain for my first ride on my repaired bicycle, which went great and it squeaks less than it ever did, and I think the spokes were loose from the start, I just didn't know to check. In addition to that, so we're going to check when the new one comes, which by the way is going to be a couple days later than expected. Shock and awe, thanks COVID. Actually, the company screwed up and sent me someone else's tracking number first, and then they sent me mine a couple days later. But as I was riding back after the storm had hit really hard, the wind was insane. There was a medium-sized busted branch of black locust covered in seeds right across the walkway. So I stopped my bike and I got the branch out of the way and I harvested all the seeds, and I have like literally a big peanut butter tub full of black locust seeds, and they're thornless. That whole branch and all of the little bits of branch were completely thornless. If you have seen a few of my videos, you'll know that I have had the hardest time getting black locust to transplant. I have killed I don't know how many black locusts that, you know, it wasn't like they were gonna live where they were. They were in the middle of the lawn, or they were growing out of the crack of a sidewalk, or blah, 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 blah. So it's not like I'm going around killing them, but it is that I just cannot transplant these successfully. They all die. So super excited to have seeds. Probably gonna put them all through here so that I can create pull wood and have them, like, this new terrace section that I'm starting is probably going to be largely black locust seeds being planted in. And look at that barge down there. Whew. I don't think this video is going to last long enough for you to see it full, so we'll just take some weird angles through the trees. So we only got 20 seconds left. We'll see. They're super slow though. Wouldn't it be nice to see a little better? Oh well, sorry. Maybe I'll just do a cameo of it. We'll do a real short barge video next. Take care. Bye.